guys, welcome back to the video. If you're new here, then do subscribe to my weekly freelancing newsletter. It's totally free and it's over WhatsApp, so check it out. It's pretty amazing. More than 2,000 people have already signed up, so you might as well give it a shot. Today we're going to talk about the harsh reality of making money online, right? As someone who has sent out hundreds of cold emails, and as someone who has done hundreds of cold calls to get clients, and as someone who has worked with like 5-6 projects, I know it is tough to make money online. It's tough to get clients, it's tough to learn a skill, and a lot of things are tough in this space. Have you seen that on YouTube? बहुत सारे वीडियोस मिल जाएंगे विच से हाउ टू मेक मनी ऑनलाइन, वर्क फ्रॉम होम, कॉपी पेस्ट जॉब, टाइपिंग का ही जॉब है, आई अर्न $100 इन 2 hours, डू डिजिटल मार्केटिंग, डू शॉपिफाई, डू ड्रॉप शिपिंग, थिंग्स लाइक दैट. देयर इज अ लॉट ऑफ क्लटर, ऑलराइट, एंड ऑल ऑफ दीज गाइज प्रमोट समथिंग कॉल्ड द गेट रिच क्विक स्कीम. ठीक है, लाइक जस्ट फॉर द सेक ऑफ गेटिंग व्यूज पीपल पुट आउट वीडियोज सेइंग हे यू विल अर्न $100 इन लाइक बाय जस्ट typing on your laptop, or you'll just earn $100 by copy pasting. Most of these are scams. There are even apps, like a lot of apps which say, forward this message to 100 other people and you'll win an iPhone, or forward this message to 10 other people and you'll get $100. All of these are essentially something that's never going to work out. And it's surprising that a lot of people fall for it. Bahut sare log, but they get scammed in these, they get stuck in these, right? I know a lot of people who think that dropshipping is cool, dropshipping allows us to earn a lot of money, and they start doing it, but ultimately they never have sales and they just waste time and resources. So have you seen that on YouTube? There are a lot of videos about how to make money, how to get rich quick, things like that. और वो वीडियोस को पीपल गेट मिलियंस ऑफ व्यूज फॉर दैट बिकॉज अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल आर रियली डेस्परेट टू अर्न मनी. लाइक दे थिंक अर्निंग मनी ऑनलाइन इज वेरी सिंपल एंड आई कैन लाइक रिलैक्स इन अ बीच इन थाईलैंड एंड जस्ट डू समथिंग ऑन माय लैपटॉप एंड अर्न मनी. इट्स नॉट दैट ईजी गाइज. इट्स समथिंग, फ्रीलांसिंग इज लाइक सुपर टफ, एस्पेशली व्हेन यू आर गेटिंग स्टार्टेड, एंड अ लॉट ऑफ यू गाइज डोंट इवन हैव द रेलेवेंट स्किल्स टू बी एम्प्लॉयबल. To be honest, India has a shortage of skilled labor. I'm not sure if you know this, but you can look up the statistics. India has a shortage of skilled labor. A lot of people don't have relevant skills. A lot of people don't know how to make great websites, but they want to earn money. Because people think of the end goal, right? People want $1 million. People want a Lamborghini, but no one thinks about the path that leads them to get that Lamborghini. No one thinks about, okay, today I'm gonna start a web agency, I'll get my clients by doing some cold emailing, and once I get one particular client, I can get some referrals, and after getting those referrals, I can expand my services, I can start a SaaS-based chatbot startup, and then, have like few omni-channel communication channels, and that way I can expand, this way I'll have a good monthly recurring income, and then I can get few investors on board, and after like 10-15 years I'll be able to afford a Lamborghini. That's called a plan. Thinking about a Lamborghini and then watching those Tai Lopez videos or Kevin David videos where they just live a flamboyant lifestyle and they just show off their cars, girls and houses, that's not really the way to go forward with it, right? The internet has a lot of videos which has disillusioned people to think that making money is easy. Remember guys, the economy works in a very different way. It works on a simple principle of supply and demand. If there is demand for something and if you're supplying it, then a transaction takes place and that's how you earn, right? And there is demand for web development. There is demand for, there's a lot of demand for machine learning. There's a lot of demand for graphic designers, good graphic designers, good machine learning engineers, good web developers. So my point is, instead of just focusing on the make money part, forget about that. Get good experience, build a good network, and work on real projects, right? Because you need to become expert in it, you need to master a particular skill, and only then you would have the relevant authority to demand money and to get paid. Now, if you're watching this video, then you fall into one of these four categories. A is people who just want to earn money without knowing how to do it. They just want to earn money. So the only criteria, the only aim in life is to earn money, but they don't know how to do it. The second type of people are people who haven't started learning a skill. So people who do not have a skill at all, but they know that only if they learn a skill, they'll be able to earn money. Third type of people are people who are trying to learn a skill and they are in the process of learning it. And the fourth type of people are people who already know a skill. They have worked on, they can work on good projects, but they're looking for clients. So let's take, I've already told you about the first type of people who just want to make money. That's not going to work out. Go learn a skill, do something, go do some online courses, work on few internships, do few projects, personal projects, have a portfolio built, and only then you can approach clients. Second type of people who are in the process of learning skill. Great, it's good to see that you have taken up the initiative to go and learn a skill. Do online courses, work on projects. As I said, project-based learning is more important than just looking at the syntax and just looking at the online courses. Whatever you learn from the course, build a project, build something of your own, get some experience. It's totally fine if you don't get paid. Do an unpaid internship, it's totally fine. Try something out. Third type of, the last type of people who have a skill, people who have a good portfolio, but still they aren't getting clients. So here you'll have to leverage LinkedIn. As I said, I've spoken about this multiple times in my past videos. Use LinkedIn, keep posting about your work, keep telling people about what you're working on so that, even they come to know about you. Keep DMing people on LinkedIn, get emails and start cold emailing. Like out of 100 cold emails that you send, one person would accept. And most of you don't even know how to write a good email or how to DM someone professionally, and I totally understand it. As an amateur, even I did not know how to approach someone professionally. So there's a good book called Pajama Profit by Varun Maya, where he has this entire section that teaches you how to get clients, right? And it's amazing. He talks about cold emailing, about how the template of the cold email should look like, and how to get the person on the call. Like, one of the major learnings from that book is that every time you approach a client, don't just WhatsApp him or DM him. Try to get him on a call, right? So your ultimate aim, like whenever there's a transaction involved, mostly call hota hai, right? Kyunki call pe aap negotiate karte ho pricing. So this is for people who already have a skill and are looking for clients. So try to get them on a call. DM him bhi bolo ki when will you be free for a call. And call me, you negotiate, and if you're just starting out, agar aapke paas zero experience hai, then it's fine if you just get paid 1000 rupees or 500 rupees or 1500 rupees. It's fine if you get paid less. You'll at least have the credibility, right? Kuch to seekhne milega, and you can also use that client name. Agar wo client ko aapka kaam pasand aaya, he might as well give you referral or more work. So it's fine if it's your first project and you're working at a very low rate. My only point is get some experience, right? So another way of approaching clients would be to use platforms like Craigslist, right? Try out Craigslist. It's a US listing platform. They list out a lot of jobs over there. You can try applying to one of them. Then talent.hubstaff, Upwork, all of these sites. Try out all of them and do it. Another approach that you can take is to think of an industry level problem. For example, if make yourself industry specific. Like, I used to work on chatbots, and chatbots to bahut sare companies hai. So what I did was we made it specific to just healthcare. So sirf healthcare companies ko approach karenge hum. That's what we have decided as of now. And if you double down on one particular niche, to wo niche ke log will keep talking about you. So you can just specialize in that particular niche. So just focus on one industry, or wo industry mein agar aap kaam karoge, then the chances of you getting more projects increases, right? So that's my advice to people in the fourth category. And yeah, so ultimately, don't fall for these online course scams. Not everything is a scam, but most get rich quick, or you'll earn money in 2 hours, you'll earn money in you'll buy a Lamborghini in 2 hours. Most of them are just fake. They're just hooks. Tai Lopez ka example le lete hai, right? Tai Lopez, aap jante hoge, is an online marketer. He puts ads with like fancy cars and fancy houses. And ultimately, his aim is to make you buy his course, which costs like, I think, $300 or $1,000, something like that. So, what expensive courses they sell you, and I don't think that's a good way of doing it. There's a shortage of skill, so learn good skills, learn how to use databases, learn how to use tools like Microsoft Power BI, learn how to do data visualization, data analysis. There are so many things, right? So yeah, that's pretty much it, guys. I hope you like this video. This was more of an awareness video because I made a video a couple of days back about how to make money, how I made money in college. And a lot of you guys, you know, that's one of my most popular videos. And to be honest, make money videos become popular for some reason. But very few people take action on it. Very few people learn a real skill. So don't do things like data entry. Go learn a good skill which will make you employable. And that way, I think getting a job or an internship shouldn't be that difficult for you. So that's my take on it. I'll see you in the next one. Take care. Bye-bye. And do subscribe to my weekly newsletter. See you.